Hello everybody, my name is Leo and with this video I would like to share with you a demo review of the Strymon Iridium, which is an amp modeler and impulse response cabinet simulator in a pedal format. These are the main characteristics of the pedal. It offers three amplifier models crafted by Strymon using their proprietary matrix modeling system. The amp modeled are a Fender Deluxe Reverb called Round, a Vox AC30 called a Chime Amp based on the brilliant channel of the AC30, a Marshall Plexi Super Lead 1959 called Punch Amp. It is then preloaded with 9 impulse response cabinet simulator, 3 for each amp with 24-bit and 96 kHz conversion, and the higher length is 500 milliseconds, so pretty big. You can also run your own IRs, loading them with the specific software downloadable from the Strymon website and connecting the pedal using the USB jack. This one. It has an hybrid IR algorithmic room control with selectable small, medium and large rooms. It has simple amp style controls for drive, level, bass, middle and treble. It has a discrete JFET analog front end, and this is a very nice feature. It has stereo inputs via a TRS adapter cable, stereo outputs and a dedicated headphone output placed here. It has a dedicated expression pedal input in two modalities. One called expression mode for morphing between knob positions and the other one called volume mode for volume control. It is compatible with Strymon Multi-Switch Plus for remote selection of up to 4 presets. It features MIDI controls accessible via EXP jack from remote parameter control and access to 300 preset locations. It requires Strymon MIDI EXP cable. It operates at instrument and line level input sources and runs at 9V and 500 mA. Let's now hear some more sounds. Before starting the sound test, let me say that we are gonna use a pretty dynamic riff in order to also check out the dynamic response of the amps. We will go through all the amps and all the caps, having a drive in the middle, and then we will do the same thing going through all the amps and all the caps with the drive all the way up. So we can hear clearly the amps, the responsiveness of the amps and how the drive affect the sound. Let's start with the Fender and with the drive in the middle position. Thank you. So final tough. First of all, let me say that I've seen a lot of YouTube videos where the Iridium is compared to an Helix Stomp or other amp simulators, but well, to me it is more similar to the Torpedo Kabam, this one, that by the way I've reviewed in my channel. In fact, in my opinion, the Kabam and the Iridium are very similar in terms of form factor. They both have only an ambient or room reverb as regard time-based effects, and they have a few differences like full amp simulation in the Iridium with stereo outputs and MIDI control functions, where the Kabam has a power amp simulation without preamp, no stereo output, but also with a DI output and so on. And let me know in the comment below if you are interested in a direct comparison between the Kabam and the Iridium. As regard the pros, first of all, I agree with all the other reviews of this pedal I've seen so far, saying that this is a plug-and-play pedal and very easy to use, with all the main controls under your fingers that allows you to easily customize your tone like a real amp. Then it is pretty small and lightweight, so it can be easily added to our pedal boards. Third pro is the sound. The amp simulator are just good, and it is a pleasure to be played and very inspiring. Well, I have to say that all the Strymon pedals I've tried so far are very inspiring, and this one makes no difference. Where inspiring for me means that you cannot wait to play it, and once you play it, a new song's idea flows out spontaneously. Four pro are the controls. This pedal offers different way to be controlled, obviously with its foot switches, but also via MIDI, giving access to 300 preset locations, or with the Strymon Multi-Switch Plus for remote selection of up to 4 presets. And it has also the possibility to attach a dedicated expression pedal. So it can be pretty well integrated with our pedalboard, and for instance with a switcher if we have a more sophisticated pedalboard setup. Let's talk about the cons. First of all, it has a mini USB connection. So now I have pedals with mini USB connection like the Iridium, pedal with micro USB connection like the Boss OD200, and I hate mini and micro USB because they are not reversible, so I'm always struggling in order to find the right way to insert them. Please, pedal builders, let's use USB Type-C. It is so much easier. Another cons is that it is possible to separate the amp section from the Cab 1, but it is not possible to separate the power amp amplifier section from the preamplifier one. So basically, when you attach an external preamp, it's like having a preamp and a cab without the power amp. It still sounds good, but to me it is a little bit weird. To be sure, I have also asked to Strymon, and this is their answer. The output mode are normal mode, amp plus cab, amp bypass mode, and cab bypass mode. In amp bypass mode, there is no amp modeling active, just the IR cab convolution engine. So it's confirmed. If you attach to the Iridium a preamp and you bypass the amp of the Iridium, you are gonna miss the power amp section. Strange choice here by Strymon. So we have reached the end of this video, I hope you enjoyed, and if you did it, please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell. It would be of a great help, and you won't lose any of the new videos I'm gonna do in the future. If you're interested in my music, you can check out the comment below, where you can find a link to a playlist of songs of mine. See you in the next video. Bye bye.